I teach movement to people for a living. It's my profession, and this time of year is a big boom in attendance because so many people use the 1st of January to, to be the day that they begin their upgrade and their improvement in some way. And there's loads of motivations there. And I've been teaching movement for about 10 years, and so I have seen students come and go, and through many different times of the year, not just at the new year. But I have noticed that one motivation that seems to keep them involved is for those students who, if they didn't come for this reason initially, they sort of got on board with self-love as a motivator instead of being inspired and motivated by self-hate. And sometimes we don't realize just like how similar these two things can look, really, really because of how we respond to both of them, that our response can be kind of similar, but that if we sort of source it back, the motivations are coming from two way, way different places. And this is important because it's like that motivation then fills the actions and fills us doing the actions. And what I mean by that is that if I love produces more love. Love grows. It's its nature to grow. It wants to expand. And hate shrinks and consumes. It's like this, black hole that just sucks all the joy. For instance, it's like if I come in with a self-love goal, then I might, come to several classes and because I've come for the class itself. Not to get rid of who I am, but to be in the class. Then I'm open to the whole experience of the class. And what I might realize is that, like, even though, I would love to have a six-pack, what I really like is being in my body. That if I'm not like judging myself, I'm discovering that I really like this body, actually, that I know it's, and we sort of we're in that moment from that self-love standpoint. Conversely, if we come in from the self-hate side of things, it's like we're waiting to get there. Like the whole class, we're waiting to get to or get rid of the thing that we came to get rid of, the fat or the bad this or the whatever. That when we come from, even if we go into like meditation, like do some sort of meditative practice from self-hate, it's like we're waiting to remove the hate item. The thing is that the hate that motivated us remains and is hungry, and it is its nature to look for something else to hate. And so I've noticed over my years of teaching movement that when people come in to the class with a motivation, and this is not always, but when they've come in with a motivation from self-hate, it's like once they get there, the hate moves on. It moves on to some other part of them, though. It doesn't leave, it just goes. It's like, okay, well, now you're in shape, but I'm gonna hate the fact that you get shy everywhere you go. It consumes. And believe me, I wish that this was just some character I was creating in my head, but I've you know, not specifically one person that's all these things, but I've met enough people that we can create a, or I can feel like there's a pretty solid character there who sometimes has the body that, you know, everybody would want, or lives in the place, or has the things, or seemingly has everything together. And inside, that person hates everything about themselves. And their sort of sense of any type of contentment is being held by this strict discipline that self-hate has convinced them that they, if they don't hold it together, if they don't hold every part of them, if they don't correct every single thing in them, that there's nothing there to love. When you start the process of working on yourself through self-love, it's like you introduce, you open the windows to that wind. You introduce this energy into your body, into your life experience. And that energy, that the self-love energy, it discovers itself in you, hidden in you, in parts of you. It's taking you, self-love is taking you on a tour of yourself and saying, yes, and you can sing too, and you can do this too. And you think this is fun, look. It's like it shows you these like bigger, more beautiful rooms of morph to love. And you want to be in that space, right? And self-hate's strangely sort of parallel. It just shows you everything that's wrong in your life. It only points out the bad things. We hate them. They're the block between us and self-love. It's definitely a little spooky to think about self-love and self-hate looking alike or sounding alike in our head. But with sourcing your motivations, I think you can find the right one. And I wish you luck in that endeavor. Blessings and Happy New Year.